welcome back to my channel. Once again, I am the Sinister One, and today I will be doing a review on Butcher Baker Nightmare Maker from 1983, a Video Nasty film. And if you don't know what Video Nasty is, it's a film that was banned by the BBFC, the British Board of Film Censors. Now, what should I say to the Nazi Party? But anyways, this film stars Jimmy McNichol, Susan Tyrell, Beau Svenson, and Steve Easton. Good line of actors, especially for this film, and these actors, they've worked with the best and they've become great actors in the years to come down the line of their early careers. So, just starting out, these actors, and they did an awesome job with this film. This film has three alternate titles: Butcher Baker, Nightmare Maker, Night Warning, and Nightmare Maker. But the true title of this film is Butcher Baker, Nightmare Maker. And I'll go into the plot of this film. It's a young boy named Billy at the age of 3. He loses his parents. They end up dying, and he ends up getting raised by his aunt. And then it jumps to 14 years later, and he's almost out of high school. He's getting ready to go to college. He's got a girlfriend, and something tragic happens in the household with his aunt, involving a TV repairman, and she ends up, you know, killing him, claiming that he was trying to rape her. So anyways, these cops do some investigating, and one of the cops, of course, is the self-righteous Nazi fascist prick that doesn't believe anything and thinks that this guy was butchered, and someone, whether it be the aunt or Billy, is involved in it somehow. So he does further investigating, and he's hot on Billy's case because there's a plot twist in this film. There's a lot of plot twists, and as it comes to go on, Billy has this coach, this basketball coach, who's a homosexual, but not your typical creepy basketball cliche homosexual, a very noble guy. And turns out that TV repairman was involved with this basketball coach, and they were partners. And the detective finds this out, and he's just like, oh god, you know, somehow there's a threesome involved with this little boy Billy, and, you know, dead body doesn't add up. So he's got this vendetta against him, and his mindset, and doesn't listen to anybody, but he thinks something disturbing is going on. But Billy's aunt is this woman who just loves Billy so much to the point she doesn't want him to leave the house. Doesn't want him to leave her, and she's in need of a man in her life. So she's very desperate and very, you know, obsessed with a male figure being there in the home. So as time goes on, you get to see the change in Billy's aunt, and it just gets really, really creepy and dark. And I'll go ahead and leave it there because, you know, I don't want to give anything else away. I think I've described it enough, but it is a great 1983 horror film. The filmmakers, the producer, director, when they made this film, they did not really consider it a horror film. They just considered it a great piece of art that, you know, they didn't want it to be like all the other slasher films out there that were, you know, in this time, in this early decade of the 80s. So they don't consider it a horror film. They consider it, you know, just a more of a character study type of film. And I can see where they're going with that. And, you know, their violence and the people getting slaughtered. You know, it takes a little time for it to get there, but it does get there, and it does make you want to vomit, but either way, it's still a great film and a very hard film to come by. This is one of the obscure 1980 films of the horror genre, and Code Red releasing, and I went to their website. They got the best of the best there, but for some reason you can't buy this from them. It just, the link isn't there. So I waited and waited and waited, and finally one day on eBay two copies came up, and I bid and won on one of them. Paid extremely a lot, but anyways, I'm a collector, so I'm glad to have this film. And you can find the title Night Warning on Amazon pretty easy. But I didn't want that title. I wanted Butcher Baker Nightmare Maker. So now that I have it, I'm happy. And a little bit of the history of this film. There's a lot of history in this. Susan Tyrell, who is deceased now, she died in 2012, but she's got a great interview on here. And she was kind of, you know, disturbed of watching this film, because she says after she made the movie, she's like, oh, I never watched it and I don't care to watch it. But when she started watching it, she's like, all right, this, you know, this was a really good film. But in her own little unique way, it was a great interview with her. And Jimmy McNichol, you know, he went on to do other films, and he was involved in music. And he really enjoyed making this film, and they had a lot to say about Bo Svenson, because they said, you know, he was just a brute of a man and, you know, demanded a lot, but that was just his personality. They said he was great to work with. And then Steve Easton, who now I think he lives somewhere in LA, California, but hometown here in Tucson, Arizona, he says after making this film, he was talking to a young actor, and the young actor was saying, you know, I'm never gonna make it, you know, I'm never gonna make it, you know. He was just like crying, saying, you know, I'm never gonna make it in this industry, you know. So they talked, and then they went on their own ways, and Steve Easton says, now that actor is Bill Paxton, and I'm not. So, yes, Bill Paxton has a cameo in this film. He shows up a couple times, and very young. And yes, one hell of an actor, Bill Paxton. I mean, he's been in a lot of these genre films, and he's made it in his career, so I gotta give him credit on that. You know, everyone loves Bill Paxton, so love these films, because, you know, you gotta start somewhere. And I said it once and I'll say it again, the genre created Hollywood, and that's hands down, and I don't care what your argument is, it is what it is. So again, Butcher Baker Nightmare Maker, I'm gonna give it, you know, 4 stars, just because of the gore, and the plot was really good. It was real solid. There's a love story in it. I love the ending. The ending was really good. It wasn't too cliche like most of the butcher films of this time, the genre. It was a really good ending. And the beginning was really good. I love the beginning. It captures you right away. And then the middle, it was a little slow, but you got to learn about the characters, you know, so that was great. You actually got to feel for each character, and you got to know them pretty well. So that's why I give this movie 4 stars. And the producer, you know, they rented this, you know, house out in the hills, and you know, they refurbished it and painted it and they rented it, so the owner got a nice deal out of it, and they used it as some of the extra rooms as wardrobes, so the actors can go and change, so they didn't have to pay for RVs and such. So I thought that was pretty cool. When you're making a low budget film, you gotta make that budget go the distance, and I think they did with this one. And yeah, Butcher Baker Nightmare Maker, I mean, if you can get your hands on it, I would definitely, you know, recommend it. But it was a hard pickup, so Night Warning is out there, but this title right here, The Code Red, you know, very hard film to come by. And on that note, I'll be doing the beer of the week. And this is one beer that's been brought up to my attention, saying, you know, do the review on this beer because it's such a great beer. And that is Glenn & Kugel's Summer Shandy. And I have to say, this beer is amazing. Salute to Butcher Baker Nightmare Maker. Oh, I don't know, it's perfection. Grade A. So, Danny Farmer and Steve Albrecht, they wanted me to do a review on this beer, and here it is, and dedicate this review to you guys. Great stuff. And I will be doing more reviews coming along, so stay tuned. I know I've been taking some time, but I'm gonna start dishing them out. This is the Sinister One, and I'll see you next time.